All right, so we are recording currently, grinding it up. Session number 8. I write that down. Session 8. It is Friday night, 7:30. 7:30 p.m. And I'm feeling a lot better. And I will explain why. First of all, let's get some of the games rolling that we usually do. We will just do these ones. Okay, we got some trumpeters. Not ideal, obviously. Games get a little bit tougher at this time. It's not super duper ideal for this game. It's not terrible. Let's open up Old Manager. Be more aggressive into our thought processes and not be a pussy. I was kind of thinking in the past few sessions, it's like, what is my life becoming if I become just this loner poker player, right? It's all about having people in your life. So that the money you make from poker can be more worthwhile. And so I was talking, a good talk with Graham about my involvement with the group or lack thereof. Every time that they ask me for a party, I'm always like, no, I'm doing poker stuff. And I would get really frustrated too if I had a friend that kept doing this, blowing me off or whatever like that, and saying next weekend, next weekend, next weekend, because it just feels like it's never happening, you know? So I promise tomorrow night, and I'm working hard tonight on the poker sessions. I might do two. I'm thinking just the one for now, because if I do two, it'll go about to midnight, but it won't be terrible. And I'm just going to be chilling. If I have any tough decisions, I will say them out loud. But other than that, I'll just chill with some music right now. And then tomorrow, I'll get up, do a workout of sorts. I might run the trail or something. I might do a workout, something like at the gym. The pool's not open until like 3:30, I don't think. So that's not really feasible. I want to do something a little earlier than that. But we'll definitely do something. And then we'll do some sessions tomorrow. And then we'll be ready for tomorrow. Probably have everything done by about 5 or 6 p.m. So we can be ready to just chill with everybody else later in the night. Then we'll do a couple sessions on Sunday later in the day. But then that'll be it. You know? We always got to make sure we have the gym workouts and the food in there. That way everything is worthwhile. So now we're just going to wait for the games to load up. And I'm thinking that for this duration of the $1,000 challenge, we'll just do the 9-man sit and goes. I'm not really into going for the higher variance tournaments. Even if they are just 27-man and 18-man, I find I just focus that much better for the 9-mans. And I can just kind of not really think about it and just be like, okay, final three get paid, final four I can push on bubble here. It's like doing those kind of things. And so without really having to think, I can just make my decisions. That way I don't have to do so much hard thought and everything like that. Incorporate the knockouts and the regular tournaments and we'll be good. What are our FPPs at? In the 600s yet? 650 about. Pretty good. And definitely going to be silver starring this for sure. 4 days, 200. Pretty good. I'm about to get a game loaded up here. Now we wait. So yeah, I'm not going to be doing any tournaments for the duration of this $1,000 challenge. It'll allow me to focus better and see what I can really do with my true ROI. But yes, like I said, now we wait for everything to open up. Against a Russian, what's his name? TK Numbers. TK Numbers is doing right, that's good. I'm not sure we will see if we have any stats on him before. I'm liking the new Justin Bieber stuff. So put that on there. Ace 3 suited from out here. Not ideal, but we can open it for sure, I think. We don't have to open it, but we can. What's Trump thinking about? It's been pretty aggressive. I was not going to re-race all in though anyway, just because it's two Ivarians. Queens, obviously, that's why I did that. There's just no point, really, leading our chips there. The fuck was he doing with the queen jack suited? Cheaper. What do? We check race. They limp though. I mean, if you have pocket fives, it just sucks, but we got to get value out of this right now. I feel if they had like 10-9 or king 10, they would definitely float, so we gotta make it big. Or valuable hands such as ace jack suited. Let's go for all the chips. Four nine against an ace four. Really not sure what this Vandal guy was doing. It's not a terrible, it's not a bad open. Jackson suit just plays so well. I'm not sure why TK is limping, honestly. No idea. He limp raises. Obviously, he's got aces. It makes no sense. It looks so much like a set mine, honestly. You re-raise anybody, it looks super strong on their part. We obviously have the value, the red raise size. There's our 10 ball. Hearts, of course, are in their range. Calls. 8-9, ever. We have Jack 10, but that doesn't really change much. He's calling pretty. We're gonna actually just check back. There's nothing we're gonna get value out of at this point. 9-8. Yeah, he turned the straight. Really makes no sense in his play. I'm disappointed that that's what happened in the hand. Being a suited's decent, but it's not great. I'd prefer a suited connector always. But you like Jack 10 suited. Big pot in the top left. We have Chamber TP up here. I have a king jack against an ace seven. What the fucking fuck? That's what all I have to say about this hand. I would like to know how. Okay, who is this guy? Vandal. Gotta wait for more Syndicos to load. I'm not loving doing tournaments, however, are there any tournaments that are worthwhile actually doing? I really don't want to do tournaments, but if there's any small, cheaper ones, obviously there's the big and stuff like that, but I want to do something that I can have started not too long ago. You know what I'm saying? Before I even know. And it's like in 19 minutes. So there's nothing going on. $11 for this tournament. We're not doing $11 for any tournaments. So we're going back to Sit and Goes. Any multi-table ones that are worthwhile? 17 out of 27. Do we give another shot at this? Honestly, I'm thinking we do. I'm thinking we play it a lot better. This was completed about 3 minutes ago. We're not doing the 45 minute because obviously that's not going to get up and running. We have a few games going. I guess we always have to evaluate. We just do like single sales all the time unless something way different happens in our schedule. It is a straight. Not really sure what the other guy was doing with Queen Jack. And really, 5-4 was a bit weird in that hand. Just play the spots as they come. Appropriately. We have King Queen, we can definitely defend this. See a flop with it, and so forth. This game is going for like 10 minutes. We have another game. Nelson, he's Nelson. Didn't 3-bet KK pre-flop in position, very passive. Or trappy. Oh, we got a Walker King King. That's surprising. We will load this one and see which things load up first, obviously. Let's start with off with 6, I think. Any, nope. We have 2 for the knockout, which I'm sure is Trump and myself. This is the only one that's not. Not sure why that's an adjusted beaver. aces against three motherfucking four. Okay, honestly, that was weird as fuck. Rook B10 suited. Gotta focus on this hand. We have a straight and everything got there. Well, I think we just call, honestly. I was straight. It's like everything got there, but it's for the small price. Sure, I mean, if you really want to, man. Sometimes things just don't work out, right? Play them as best you can. Guy on this one. We got a guy named Celia. So the worst hand we've loved is there again. We got the 27 man. In vain, oh, Ron, no, what do you mean? Oh, come on, give me just the lyrics, man. Don't show all of this shit in there. He's forcing me to work him off. Yeah, we can definitely call. It's not terrible, it's not great. We need spades, though. Open 6x. This big up there. I have a backdoor spade draw and also a gut shot to the five. Depends how big the bet size is. If it's like full pot, obviously we just get rid of it. We just have not the correct odds to continue in the hand. Over pairs are definitely in his range. So here I have like a king queen that he's just betting super huge with. If we get raised, it's just like a disgusting. If we get a donk for tiny, we just call. And we hit our gut shot, no big deal. Perfect miracle card. And it's a Badoogie board. So I think we just call. Let him think he's good. That jack is not terrible. I mean, a queen's not terrible on the river. And now I think we can shove all in. Calls with Queen Jack, like we got him. Got the first casualty. Oh yeah, here we go. You better make up your mind, what do you mean? Oops, shit. He calls me an idiot. He's got no idea what he's talking about. That's so small there, it's completely fine with me. We'll call here. We don't need to. We're on the button. Do we check back? I feel like they're both kind of weak. 16 to be called for 20 bigs is not the best of situations. He c-bets everything, but it's going to be a situation where just we're not in the best of shape. If there was more callers, it'd be better. Call 60, trying to win, only like 700 more. It's really not going to turn out that great for us a lot of the time. We got trump and deuce sides here, two trumps. And we'll just evaluate and see when different things work out. We will take away the multi-table aspect to it. We don't need to open this from right here. There's different things happen in different kinds of sit and goes, right? Roxing. It's pretty decent for sure. At the SMGs. Ace 9 suited. The 9-man sitting goes play differently though than the larger field tournaments and stuff. Got a race to 223. I don't know why players start betting 223. Pot's like 120 or something. Ace 10 against an ace 3. It's a pretty sick turn. It's huge matchups. We'll just let them take it. It's fine. All in call. Ace jack against pocket queens. What are you doing with this jack, man? Here with an ace jack. Pretty funny. And I really want to know, what do you mean? Capros, in the whale. I really want to know, what do you mean? That one sitting goes not looking too good for us for sure. Nines, here we go, I think. Do we raise it? How big? It's not super huge yet, so we'll just make it 2.5x. But I really want to know. Pretty weak. You could have a jack, obviously. Doesn't have to have a jack either. Now we have a KK dream. Pretty good. Definitely trying to get involved. Fucking ace on the flop. Sucks. It's gonna look like a really wide range. Well, I'll give him the, I think he's protecting against hearts. We underrepresent our range, but the ace killed it. Pretty fishy. Guy is pretty fishy. Let's check out the multi-table one suit just in case. 727, yeah, nothing's really getting going. Not really interested in making it going either. But man, I really want to know. But what do you mean? Okay, that's one. Wow, a wall. A play. Please don't just call again. Ace, king, with pocket queens. King's gone. I think they all just call. I don't think there's any real worthwhile making the raise bigger. Maybe I'll call. That's not terrible, though. You know what? Well, you sleep. Get just the fish. Really? Anybody gonna continue here? Man, I really want to know. You're now can't. I don't think he's gonna continue. I think it's just gonna be me and Yomas. Wow. Now I'll limp. Can we bet huge on the turn? Limp so much of his range. I have aces down there. It's pretty sick. 150. Do we let him barrel into us? What is he going to have? He limps, then he just barrels huge. I think we actually can call, call, call. Pretty fair sized bet. What does it mean? When he bets like this, what does it mean? You know what? I'm not feeling the most confident about it. Kind of feels a... We're going to fold it. Shouldn't have really been on the flop, but at least we'll just get rid of it now. It's not a good spot. But dude, I really want to know, what did you mean? I mean, now we've got that many, right? Oh, I really want to know. We'll just call because I feel like this one's going to go crazy enough. All we have is a gut shot. I think I could definitely be the winner at the same time. Not always. It's hard to continue on a board like that. I just gave up some quick tips there. Not a big deal, obviously. What do we really want to know? What do you know? Kings against an ace nine. Kings are good. Victory's not so good. Seven. First check raise, I don't know anymore these days. Check raise is really weirding me out. Hey, oh, we got one. Nice. I think it's going to depend on whether or not we can survive, right? Trumpeter. And how do you answer? We'll see. I think we have to go with this. Do we have any knockouts? We have one up there. We have ace king here. Calls with sevens, flipping. Hoping for the ace or nine. Come on, ace or nine. Did not get there. That's unfortunate. We have 50 big lines here. He's going to be doing this with a wide range of holding, so we will raise it up. Dude, I really want to know. There's nothing worked in this single. Didn't win a flip. Didn't win that hand. A few hands would be refreshing. We just did not make it work. And we got ace king again. This time's on the button. Really want to know, but what do you mean? And we'll just black call. Oh, call. I have a flush draw up here. It's pretty sick. Board is paired though, so obviously somebody's got pocket kings. And obviously here, the four got there. There's my king ball, which might be unfortunate. This might be unfortunate. We can't really pay off a huge bet here. Good shot. He calls. He's got two pair a lot of the time. I think we can just flat call again here. Need hearts or a queen. It's not quite what we're looking for. Gonna shove. We can't call. We can't call here either. Everything got there. We're actually going into folding mode. You're so indecisive. Just fold here as well. We got Fred. What did Fred do? He's calling me again. You get a raise, it's weird. DK! Dude needs miracle. That's not a miracle. We're gonna actually give him a raise to 62 this time. And I think here with this many or this few chips rather, my question is, do I want to raise all in? I think raising all in might be decent. It's not terrible. No, we're just gonna min it. Both options are not terrible. Okay, now we're definitely gonna call. Could have definitely c-bet. I just felt like the c-bet was being done quite often. Tens, kings, unfortunate. Cooler. Got jacks at the bottom table. We have an ace nine. BBB against Trump. You want to call with ace 10? A 3-bet. Kind of liking the 3-bet option. I think I just go with it anyway. I'm not really sure. Ace 9 here. Fred. Oh my goodness, Fred. Not loving it, obviously. I think I just got to fold. Speaking of folding, I think when he raises this big, what did he say? If he's donkey out of position, any sort of made holding, we're going to actually just outreach shove. I feel like against his range, it might make it work. This could definitely work against him. Eights. See what I'm saying? Unless that specifically happens. Queen six against queen eight. We have a six though. Need a seven or an eight. Anytime you can get it in as a favorite, that is definitely what you want to do. So we've been eliminated from two. Definitely shove this all in. Do what I really want to know. What do you mean? We'll just flat call. Ace queen against king 10. No king 10. No king 10. No king 10. Now we're back up to a decent stack. We can do what we need to do in a lot of cases now. Threes, we did not hit a set. I'm still disappointed that nothing worked out. When I had the jacks versus his eights, flopped an eight. Trumpeters on both. We had another knockout going through, generally a little softer, they call a little wider. Gonna do something with force. It aces against a 7-6. Wow. Trumpeter is going, we will just call for 40. Not a huge fan of calling, but we have a hand that we can do something with, right? So we'll go with it. Once again, no set. We don't even have the spade, so we can't continue. Now we have threes. We're finding a lot of pocket pairs and shit to go with here. Set time. It's so many pocket pairs, you got a set, right? Kind of building half the times here. See that flop in the far left? We could have dealt with that. King eight ball. Bet out 99. Definitely worthwhile. Get our chips back. Then we can also get this one going if we put it possible. Yeah, I think we've been eliminated from two at this one. I don't think we can call the king. It's a little bit too wide. I guess we're flipping. We're never shoving. You can always be shoving ace king or ace queen, but never shoving king jack. You're so indecisive. I really want to know what do you mean. Shove a queen five BBB, I think. He's going to be limping a lot, but we can't beat his limping range, I think. Trying to make best decisions in both tournaments. We can definitely get there. 8-6, I don't think we can do anything with. We're just gonna fold it. Got 8-6 and two tables. Same 8-6 as well. Jack 5. More like jack shit. There's our shove from our friend. Actually, he's not our friend at all. We don't really care about him. Ace king against pocket sixes. Looks like a flip preflop. 8-5 suited, I think. It's actually not too bad to shove. It's a bit wide, but it's not terrible. 8-5 suited. We have not shoved yet. We have, but it's been good hands, right? Kofros might see through it in a sense of being like, I got a good hand, I go with it. But every now and then you gotta do those. Not often. Because if you do it too often, you're gonna be fucked. Every now and then, though, when you see a decent spot where no one's like been raising it up, it seems like a pretty passive table. It just seems like the right time. You gotta do something like that. But as I said, not often. It's gotta work a huge percentage of the time. We got jacks against a set of sevens here. Jack or eight is what the guy needs. He did not get there. That is a good pot for Trumpeter. That's what he wanted. That is what he's trying to do when he does all this. We have ace queen in the bottom left. Probably good for a poke. Begin 3x. Sorry, not 3x. 2.5x. Our ace 9 here. We have a tight player doing something here. That's 7. Take it down. We have backdoors. Depends if they connect with it, because if they connect with it, we can still get there. He shoves all in. We can actually go all in with this too. Okay. They're never doing this with ace jack. Okay. Alright, I'll get rid of my ace queen. It'll be interesting to see what kind of holdings they have. Like, I mean, they can have pairs. We'd be flipping. Kings, ace eight. There's an eight ball. What a Nelson fold here. Pocket threes. I had ace queen. Made the correct fold. I was actually going to reshove against him, which would have been correct, although I would have lost the hand. Oh, I really want to know. What do you mean? Dude. We have a fish here. Kind of an aggro donkey type fish. We don't need to raise this up. I feel like D-Man, where's he from? Canada? Canada. 6 to 7, I think we had like 11 big blinds. Lots of shovey wubby stuff gonna have to happen. Miles from Ukraine, wish. Trump knows the shoving ranges too. Got a king 10. Walk to TK. We have A7, that's pretty good. We can call off some blind versus blind and like lay position shoves with his hand for sure. However, when he raises up, even though he's raised up big, I think A7 is a little too weak. It was A10, I think I might go with it. It's probably the lowest though that I'm going with, A10. Did everyone 3-bet here? I think so. 303 or 299. We have an ace blocker, he's been raising a lot of hands. We can see that I'm doing him a lot of the time at field here. Obviously, if he reshoves on us, we just fold, but this is the type of spot that looks really strong. He's not going to say anything. I was going to say, like, me too. It's like, you know, I really don't need to. We can go either way with a raise here. We have chipped up. It's about knowing your chip up spots in these, I feel. We've not gotten any games going at all in the nine man's off to the side. So it's unfortunate that the other one busted so fast. Ace Jack against pocket aces. The fuck is the guy doing an ace jack? Well, ace ace came, so the guy with aces has got a lock basically, which he just completed. And if he raises, we can just call in position with the queen 10. There's a queen. Plays nicely. D6. Could have completed with that. We don't need to go there. Don't think we need to shove the 5-9s, but too wide. Fold these hands. We have any knockouts? One up here. That's it right now. We have threes. We can definitely complete with this holding. Is Trumpeter still here? Yes, Trumpeter's still here. What else? Any other regulars? No. No other regulars. Just us. Doing our thing. Okay. I'd hate it if you raise a few. It's like 223. Okay, well, I guess I gotta fold now. Playing it for our set value. Complete. Three ball. Nope. We can shove this for sure. He's gonna be raising wide. I think we just have to reshove. Against the type of hands he's gonna be doing this with, I think that is definitely good enough. 2-3-4. Do we ever go with it here after all these limps and shit? Number two. I think we can. A lot of weakness shown. We can check it back a lot of the time. We can also just take it down here, what it looks like. Ace Jack's pretty good. Ace Deuce is also pretty good. 9, not good enough. Looks like we're getting one kind of going. What is his thing? Okay, those from first. I'm kind of curious as to what it was, not really sure. Ace 2, against a deep stack like this, it's not really worthwhile. We have aces here that is worthwhile, to say the least. I don't think it's worthwhile popping it up here. He's going to be doing this with a lot of holdings. It could do something, but it's really not the best. We don't need to call it here either with that. Aces are folded, which is unfortunate. Boom, 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 boom. Can't really do anything with a jack 3. So we just fold it to Pablo. He's going to know his calling ranges and shit. Just gotta understand how we can shove, how we can get value, how we can do different things in the sit and go, for sure. 9-4 does not look like it. Just trying to find ways to survive. That's all. Ace Jack. We can call some hands. We got two Jack 10 suiteds, and none of them have free rolls, so that will be chopped. 4-7 can't play that either. I think if Trump reshoves, we have to go with him. It's not great because he knows his ranges as well. There's a lot of regulars here. Three of them to be exact. Ace Jack, you got Ace 5-6. It's strange. We get a reshove all in from this man, and I'm not feeling too strong about that. Player 9 big, I think we just get rid of it. Eight kings last time. Don't want to have to keep folding there. I will if need be. Of course. All in. Knight of call with 2-5. It's not obviously great. Speaking of not obviously great, did we shove here with king jack? Does not look like it's too wide. Ace queen against pocket kings. He was hoping for a trap from us. And I say here, speaking of trap, we can definitely reel him in here a bit. Say a raise from us, and I say from here we can probably unregister from this one. I think we busted from three, maybe just two. Could be two or three. Not really sure. Ace jack. That's good. It's a little bit not great for us. His limping range can include these hands. Ace jack is pretty good now. I say we pump it up. To 606. We have a queen here. I say we just call here with this hand. Are you kidding me with diamonds? Are you freaking kidding me with diamonds? Does he ever shove here? I don't think he does. But speaking of shoving here, does he ever call? It's not terrible. It's not great. Can go either way. He folds. I think we do just check back. But he does a lot of the time. We have two pair. The value's pretty thin, not gonna lie. There's some straights and stuff that got there. We're just gonna check back. He could have called. I think it's pretty unlikely. So now we gotta make our decisions. We can shove with a king eight. Yeah, for sure. Calls with ace king. We actually need our eight ball, and the eight is not looking like it's gonna come. Let's get the mirror for 10, and that is not happening. We got busted after our hard work. We are double gutted now. But oy vey, oy vey. I think it was fine to shove that. How many bigs we have? Let's see. I don't want to make up your mind. What do you mean? I think we just let everything roll for now. Yes, I do the cleaning. Yes, I do the time. Yes, I do everything. I want to do that. Why would he keep checking if he didn't want to get value? It just makes no sense. Yes, we can exploit it, but what can you do to re-exploit it, you know? It's like we can exploit it much better than you can do anything about it. Eights against a jack nine suited. There's a nine. Clubs. That's it for that. Do I want to continue and put another game in? Is my question. Another game? Yes, no, maybe so. I'm kind of thinking the answer to that question is yes, just because of some of the other stuff that's going on. Matty Chop. I think we just keep these ones in the center, no matter what happens. Do we want to raise around here? I think we can. They've not shoved everything. We'll see if he wants to continue. 5-8. King is in his range. Hardly. I say we check raise. He's going to float a lot of the time in the heart. Check shove. I mean, obviously, if he has the king, we just can't do anything about it. But I just feel that a lot of the time, we can make that, can do that with a heart, and then we're kind of fuck him over. So, yeah. He's an equity plan there. Green 5 suited. I think we can shove. Potentially. We will 3-bet. To what? 3-1-1. We have 3-bet trouble a couple times. I guess we've shown up with value all those times. Sixes against an ace king. Sixes, right? That's weird. We have kings up here. Finally, a real hand. Woken up with a real hand. I'm not sure how many we've busted from so far. I think it's the count is at 3. Start with 253 and 190, which means that that's 63, which is 9. We got 6 here, and needs to be busted from 3. Yes. Okay, well, obviously we go with it. No doubt. We have aces. That really sucks to us. Kings for both of us. And none of us have a free roll. We definitely could have gone for some value. None of us have ace king. Some of us do have queen jack, though, so we play it a little bit passively. Queen jack, queen 10 is definitely in the ranges. King 10 up here against pocket kings. That is a lot of regulars. We'll just call. Let's call. Not terrible. His shoving range. How much is it? Another 700. I don't think it's worthwhile going with it. Flipping, and we have a decent amount of chips here with what we're doing with this. I see we could get something value out of some hands, not a lot. We do be looking bluff, but I think it's good to understand what is going on here. A lot of these hands, right? We could get some value out of some small jacks. 22. Obviously, we get a re-raise. I'm fucked. But we can also get value, which is what I like. King, queen suited is very strong. Yeah, jack 9. Never folds. Does he want to get aggressive with it? Do we check call ever? What kind of hands is everybody gonna show up with here? He can have a king for sure. Let's see if we check. Say against ace king. I'm showing up with here. Say we could call. Definitely call, it's not ideal. Obviously, I just feel like he's got the value holding a lot of the time there in the bottom, so that's why we did not go with it. It's not a knockout, we don't need to go with it. Queen 2 against ace 4. Yeah, there's an 8 top. I think ace 4 is good. Not sure why he did that. Kind of a stationy whale. Three bet. So we just call. Queen 10. The queen 10, honey. I think we can just call this. No. You know what? No. Alright, so we protect. 9-6. And I say here we check behind. He's not calling a lot. Could definitely go for it. Types of hands he's going to be raising and stuff. They're going to be those. He's going to have some other hands. It's not obviously great. We'll bet 172. Behind is probably not ever good. We just check, 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 check. Jack 5. Not sure why he raised. Probably trying to steal. But he understands how to make it work. He doesn't want to get too involved with it with us. We'll be fine. Final 18 tables. I think we have it disabled, right? If it comes up, obviously we turn it off. Settings. Final table background. Correct. We do not want it shown at all. We have decent chips here too in the 18 player one. Uh, show tools registered. Play games and tickets registered in tournaments we have. These ones, right? Keep good. Just making sure that we don't have any more than these. I don't think we want to get involved here. I don't think we want to get involved here too. When he raises like that. If you ever want to get involved for this many big blinds, I don't think that's a good idea. It's not terrible. We can 3-bet next time for sure. But I just feel like it's not close enough to the final table for that to actually really matter. We have a king jack. Again, I've heard 3-bet. He hardly ever 3-bets. He's like never 3-bet in my lifetime. 7-4 suited is not ideal. Call fairly wide. Gonna call fairly wide. It's not that wide. 7 is in our, and we have diamonds too. It didn't get there. Didn't quite get there. Queen 6 against aces. Once again, it's unfortunately ran to the very top of their range. It is a queen 10. Ace king against pocket 7s up here. That is a queen. What do we do with it? I really go either way in a lot of situations, I feel. Now, why would he raise? If he's calling. I feel like we can actually go for all of it here. He just flats. We're doing this with a fairly wide range of holdings. So we're going to actually put him to the test a bit. 6-0-6. We're going to shove it all. We're going to get him a shove. We're trying to actually induce with the queen 10. I think we just shove. Like, honestly, there's nothing we can do that's different. Or do we let him do his shove? 3s against an A7 that got there in the river. It's good to know. I think we check call anything. Six, five. We knew it. He's an aggro donk. That's how you gotta play those fucks. What do you mean? We'll just call. We have the chance of knocking him out. Just call again. It's fine. We have the nuts. Call, we got the knots in the river, man, and we got a knockout. Ding. Yeah, it's unfortunate. We had a lot of things just not work out the entire time. Kings, ayo. I thought it was one of the safest runouts. We can raise call against Secretary. Interesting spot for sure. You know, you do not want to get fucked out of this thing. Queen 10 is not there. A jack is there. Did we ever? Got a lot of jacks in his range. I don't like this very much at all. Interesting though, if he checks back to take the free card. I think now we can check call. Could have made that a lot more difficult for us for sure. He raises here. I think we can actually re-raise all in. the spot where not great. No, we won't. We definitely could have. What are the hands that he has in this spot? 9-10. He did have a draw as well as a pair. Could have had jack 10 very easily though. Oh, dude, I really want to know. What did you mean? Let me bust out a 4. This is highly unfortunate for us. I don't think we're doing anything super wrong either. Pocket 10s. Really not really ready any real flips. That's fine. Maybe can 3x. Did decide to fold. Oh, right. We have an ace ball. Maybe we can apply some pressure. We really have no outs, basically. We can pot control. We're just gonna flat call. Ace jack would suck for us. Do you have jack 4? We flopped a straight. The fuck are you doing? Straight, he's betting in huge run to us. Ball, max attacks. I think when he bets out this big, do we want to just jam all in? Maybe just call. 7-8 is in his range for sure. And now we just raise all in. He's gonna get it anyway. Might as well put it in. Ace 8. Wall. Big time wall. That's huge for us. Massively huge. He's gonna have a good hand here a lot of the time. I think we just have to check fold. Even with the 8 paired up. Okay, never mind. Now that all changed. Queen 10 was in his range. Now do we let him bluff at us? Because if he's not really gonna call anything, Queen 10 is definitely in his range. I think now we definitely let him bet. I think a lot of times he's gonna have flop straights in his range for sure. Some pair aces and eights. What did he have? Could he have a king 9? I feel like we could have gone for value. It was a bit of a scared thing. Ace queen, that is worrisome for us. That's unfortunate. Oh dude, I really want to know. What do you we can call, we can call. In position. Who could have the best hand here? The king kicker. Oh. Then we can see that this, as we always do. I think we can bet this out too. Wow, he check shoves. I think we got a call. We got the king. Ace 2. Yeah, exactly. As I'm saying, it's like, obviously you can have the ace of the deuce right here, but there's a lot of times he doesn't, I think. So now we are a massive chip leader. We have jacks too. So we go 3x. Pot is going to get too big otherwise. Hearts, he wouldn't check back that fast. Pot out 291. Trying to get 45, obviously. I think we're way ahead of everybody else, too. 7,000 chips. It's pretty incredible. I'm not gonna lie to you. Queens gets an ace 8 there. We raise that. We got 5, so now we're down close to the final two tables. We're gonna be calling off a lot, but if they reach out, we can't call. We're gonna be calling here a lot. We are going to put up the old min poke. 2-2-2. It's not gonna work a huge amount of the time. When it does, it's good. Because it is very good. Like right now. That is our range, right? So. Secretary shoves. Can we call the shoves? It's not terrible, it's not great. Go either way. 30 and that. We can actually 3-bet this, I feel like. 5. 94. I feel like this time you won't. Not gonna do it a lot. Not loving this spot. Don't wanna let things get there though. Queen, ace 10. Looks like a final table now. New table. Ayo. We're on the final table bubble here. I think now we got a bet fairly large on the larger side. Like 422. 416. No, we are not targeting you, we just have it every time. Queens against an ace jack. Queens take it. We have 8,000 chips. We have a lot more chips than everybody. So we can apply some fair size pressure for sure. Trump is actually in this too still, but he has not been doing nearly as well as us. We have 1,000 chips. We have a bucket more chips than everybody else for sure. Trying to get there. We are trying to get there. Bet kind of small, not too big, just do our C bet stuff. A6 is a little bit small in terms of what we can do with it. Huge blank on the river, huge blank. Maybe we can actually raise it up once again involved still. 37, how about 899 or 902? How about 944? I'm thinking at this point we do call. This makes no sense. King 9 would suck. Queen 10 did not get there. We're good. Obviously, we put the hurt on them. There's so many donks in this that we get it and we go, you know what I'm saying? He never does that stuff, so we're going to make it bigger. The ship leader here as well. That's sick. This is real freaking sick. Try to make it work. With these kind of spots, I think we can actually bet. Carol is being pretty whaley. I'm gonna try and boss this final table. We have ace king. I don't think there's any other games really going on that we really want to get involved with. We can definitely do some good stuff in these big tournaments. I feel kind of bad for Black Baron. I feel actually pretty bad for Trump in the sense how hard the guy works and all the shit that happens. But we're definitely gonna try and go in with it with queens here. Give it a small C bet. See what he wants to do with it. Do you want to give it a 3x? No, we'll give it a 3 and a 4x here. too late to say sorry. We check back. Like, there's nothing we can do about this. Four, one, two. He's not folding ever. Check. 7-9 trips. He's got an ace. He limped though. Supposed to fold everything. Think of the amount that's in the pot. What do you want to do with queens? What do we want to do with queens? We would have about 5,900. Who else has that? And there's not that many other players. There's a few other different holdings they could have here. He's going to fold a lot. It's not terrible. He could easily have an ace, though. He definitely could easily have an ace. In his range. King 4 of diamonds is also in his range, too. And that did not get there. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, fucker. I mean, that's why we still bet, right? We raise it up, and now we're going to c-bet this. This shit is working out well for us. Madalie is a whale. Where is he? Or she, rather. Maybe we just check back, because I think he's going to continue it here. That way we can do that. Actually managed to find a fold, which is interesting. Queen Jack is in that range, but I feel like he would check raise that. Flop to set. We're running really good now, which I love. Hoping we don't get really scare cards. That's kind of a scare card, but it's not actually too bad. I think now we can bet huge. Oops, shit. 1,001. 1,210. Now with 18 players here, with 1 of 5, we can definitely do something. First of 5, 4 get paid. This is sick. Super duper freaking sick. All the motherfucking chips, now we gotta try and do something with it, you know what I'm saying? There's a 5-minute break. I don't think there is in this one, though. 58 minutes, yeah, it's only every couple. Who made it to here? Trump finished a little bit while ago. Trump finished a little bit while ago here, too. Trumpeter, trumpeter. We got rid of those guys, so now we're down to us. We are alive in serious cash. We can fucking blink these. I think it's like, yeah, it's 45 there. And here it's 63. So that'd be like over 100 bucks. That'd be sick. I think we can just get it in with this guy. 311? No. 333. We'll just check. We're obviously calling. There's no way we don't call here. Ace queen against pocket kings. There's an ace. That is nice. He's a king. We have the heart. Boom. Sick. Got a bounty too. I think for the ranges of all the players, that was completely okay. Looks like we're going to do pretty well on these tables. Didn't really want to have to get involved with it there. We are on a bubble. But I think it's a fairly deep stack bubble. 5,400 chips. Yeah, that's the average, eh? The guy with 2,100 has a lot fewer. Does he ever fold this guy? No, 360. Nines against tens. Needs a nine. Did not get it. So everybody stays alive. Everybody stays alive. I think you can raise this. Kind of profitably. Not terrible, not terrible. We're just card racking on this table. 7-6. We are double gutted. Yes, we are. He check shoves. I think we go with it still. We have backdoor clubs as well. We can hit our 7 and 6 still be good. Get they shove with a 5. I don't think we can go with that. We don't want to get too crazy here. We have a lot of chips. So we can do our small ball stuff. I mean, not too small ball either. We just kind of have to figure it out. You know, we got all the chips here. We're trying to do what we can. Try to just make it work. This is a pretty good stream for sure. This one, I mean, we have a lot of chips too, but we don't have all the chips. We just got quite a few. The 18 man is where we have all the fucking chips. I think we can just call. We don't need to squeeze. It's not going to fold the squeeze. I think with the implications here, I think we'll just do that. I thought a pretty good draw. We don't really need to leave. We can just call. It's because of the amount of chips of these players on the bubble. We don't need to actually go crazy. This is a king. We have some showdown value now we can go with. We have a 9 we want to go with here. We actually check raise the 9. Now we have the flush. Not flush. Just calls, we have the nuts. Like, there's no way. Like, if you want to go crazy, go freaking ahead. Everybody calls. We got him, dude. We can actually 3-bet, I think, against Secretary. 606. Good 4-bet jam, obviously. But this is a spot, I think, that we can apply a lot of pressure. What did they all call with before when we hit that? Ace 10, 4, 6. Lol, they both hit. They all hit their meal for cards. At some point during the hand. That is an ace queen. It's not terrible. 193. So yeah, we just have all the chips here. Niles is gonna know what he's gonna do, and so even though we're first, we are gonna fold. We're opening a lot of hands. We got a couple real short stacks here, but the Carol is, yeah, he knows what he's doing. Yeah. Max kind of has to go within some spots. He should have known, though, with his ace-10, he should have folded due to the ICM implications of becoming a shorter stack here. So, yeah, now we have just rocketed up the standings. We are going to do whatever we can to make sure we get paid to the full. Like, if they want to call, they can. We're shoving, though. If he wants to go with us, sure. It's going to have nothing to do with my stack. A7 against a jack, too. There's a 7. We need a jack. 8 can chop? No. Okay. ICM them. Right over their head. He just has no idea. He's just freaking calling station. But sometimes they do fold. It's for a tiny amount of the stack, honestly. Back to live cards a lot of the time. We have aces now. Beauty, beauty, beauty. Everything's working out really well. We just gotta make sure we roll with it. Having fun being in these tournaments. 3, same thing. I don't think it's just us. You know what? This is a board we're actually going to check back. I feel like that it's not going to work out the best for us to be raising this up here. We have some backdoors we can go with. It's nice when you hit all your backdoors, too. We can get some value out of some hands. Add equity. Do we want to raise it here? We can. We have kings now, and we're in the money. Seven, 3. Try to decide what he does now. It's a good fold. 10-8, an ace-jack. Ace-jack needs help. He's done. We're in the money there. Become a bit more alive here now, I think, even though we are already in the money. Actually, yeah, because we're in the money, we actually probably shouldn't. We'll just do what we can. See if we can apply some pressure in some spots. Is it too late to say sorry? See if we can already have the best hand in some spots. This is a board that they are all over, and they're going to have like very little fold equity. So I think we should probably just not do anything with it. We just call, re-raise, what do we do here? I think we can just flat on the button. Nah. Go either way, go either way, go either way. Let me just jam it. Five, check it all the way. Ace, jack, and threes. Hey, we don't want to get too crazy here. Do what we need to do. We are far ahead of these guys. Be raising a bit, pretty high. We can figure it out from here. Definitely can fold. We have tens against an ace 10. There's the ace. I think we can just call. We're pretty deep. I think we call with the ace jack suited here. We fold here. It's not terrible, it's not great. We can go either way. Now we're raising everything so we can easily get jammed in our face. They have not been jamming in our face yet. We're actually gonna raise this up. Another 400, so 560. 5, 5. Don't need to inflate the pot too big yet. That's a queen ball. You would have thought more with it on in other situations. We are just card racking a lot of spots here. Ajax suited, we can call. It's not terrible, it's not great. Go either way. Go either way, go either way, go either way, go either way now. Getting a lot of flops. This many big blinds, I think we can just flat call. It's fine. Ace jack, like decently. We have an 8-6. You just want to check call. Yeah. So we bet if we get raised, then we just fold. With this guy, he kind of raises a bit. He's been on the more aggressive side, but we can just call here, I think. Flop a set, no big deal. I find that eights are the easiest to flop sets with, quite frankly. Just fold that, it's fine. That's out. Kind of large. Speaking of getting up kind of large, then we can apply some hurt, but I'm not really sure. Let me just in position, just do that. What do we do here, especially with that? All of it? Yeah, all of it. It's gotta be all of it. Check it. And here, I think we just call again. We do have the heart. Now we have the second nut flush. He bets all of it. I think we have to call, believe it or not. It's gonna be really gross. We're just gonna call. If there's anything better, we're gonna get worried. Jack of hearts. Whew. Is it too late to say sorry? Oh. 320 is a bit big for this pot, so I'm just gonna fold. Just kind of crushing, doing the best we can, obviously, in all these spots. Raises it up. We're actually gonna make it 9-9-9. Could easily be having a worse hand or a better hand. He wants to reshove and go ahead, but this is a spot where we can easily apply pressure. Now we got jacks down here. It is a knockout. We can definitely try and knock him out. Jack 10 against Ace Jack. Not sure why you called. We do call. Jacks against fours. That's the set for both of us. That's quads. Heyo. That's my quads. I'll check back. It's fine. It really doesn't make much of a difference to me. Oh shit, we're actually time bank. All these. Check it back, it's fine. Jack 8. Ace 4, he's still alive. He's still living. We don't really need to continue though, so we will just raise this up. A lot of things we can continue with. That is an ace 3, and that is something that he looks like he wants to continue with, so we are just going to fold the rest of the way. We're going to have a C bet. My brain's getting fried. Jesus Christ, sakes. We will raise. We do it with like everything. We will call this ace queen against sevens. We are flipping. We need a lot of Broadway. Come on, Broadway. That's not Broadway. That sucks. Oh well. We will call trumps if you shove. Ace two against king queen suited. That's a lot of clubs for us. He's got a lot fewer outs, and we are good. Ace of clubs gets the win. We could have called. I'm not really sure why we didn't. We have ace 10 now. 2.5x. Maybe we can make this larger. Nice little 3x ball. We go for it again. All in, you know what, for the bounty, 3-8. Let's go with it. Pocket fours, need an 8 ball, 3. That's a couple more outs. Come on, baby. That's not it. Okay, okay. We call. We can raise it up here. That is not the best. And that is not the best either. We'll check. King 2 with a head as well. Spending fairly large, not really sure why. Fold that, and we can call this, I think, threes against ace 9. A lot of different outs. 8, 9, jack, ace. That's one of them. Sucks. Does suck to suck. You're us. 14,000. We'll try to make sure we get there and not punt. I think we went 3 bet. Oh, I really want to know. What do you mean? How many have you gone up or down? Down a little bit, not a really big deal. Kind of crushing the final table as much as possible. We have an ace jack. 243. We can bet him out in a lot of spots. BBB, we will start raising up a little bit bigger, I think. How often does he want to play? Queen Jack needs a jack ball. We're good. Make it. Let's go. Let's freaking go, man. We have a lot of tables running that are pretty significant. We are first here, but not really in the clear for a lot of first things. call. We are having huge amount of chips. 43 minutes. It is a knockout. We will try and do the best we can. We're definitely getting paid in this one. Not really sure how much. I think we can 3-bet? It's a little light. Either way. 422. Call. No real big deal. Aggression factor is a thing. Ace King! Yes! Nigga. Let's go, let's go. 4-4. It's a little bit wide. We can peel though. We can peel 4-5. Flop bottom 2. Check raise it up. King 6. Jack 9 is a 9. Wow, that is a really bad turn of events. I think now we just check call. And now we shove. And against this range, when he does that, you know what? We're just going to call position. Pop ourselves some equity. 4-5-6-7-8. We can definitely go with it. We can definitely dig it. Ace queen. No queen, and we're good. I like the no queen. No queen or jack. The huge equity pot. Highly unfortunate. We both had a huge spade, too. Ah, my nigga. That would have been huge for us. Oh, we can only call. Ace queen. Ace. Wow, that's huge. I'd say we shove. So we are in fifth now. After climbing for so long, we drop. That equity just smashed on us. Trying what we can do what we can down here for this big boy. This big bad boy. Can't continue here, but here we can definitely do something. King Queen all in from this guy. What happens if we lose? 2,500. That's not terrible. Which I make quite a bit. I think here, 636. So here we fold, and here we call. And here, I'm really not sure. I think we can call, but it's not great. 1,200 to win that much. The equity is not great. We are going to go with it. Ace Jack. There's a king. There's a 10. He's a queen or an ace. We didn't let him get there. Oy vey, we are golden. Now we are in great chip settings. We're just going to call. Deuces. We're good. Speaking of we're good, we're going to bet big. Real freaking nigga big here. I'm thinking on the lines of like an 8. Shove a queen 5. Let's go. We can raise. It's not amazing. We'll go with it either way. It was call with our draw and stuff. $400. That way he doesn't get at us. I mean, we're just gonna call again. There's no big deal. You have a jack, you can have hearts like that, you know? Make him draw to those. Probably get frustrated. He lost a couple twos. I think here it's incorrect. We can call here. Jack 7 suited. With that range, I think we have to fold. Check this back. Check that two. Ooh, we fought trips. Speaking of two. AC, not great. you can have a dock leading range here. You will raise. You will just call. Here we actually have a straight. I don't think it's correct. You can go either way. I think we do call. We represent a lot of different things. Six is full. Very nice hand. King eight. I think we can call with a king eight. Eight, ten. It's a ten ball. That's a ten. Highly unfortunate. We don't get there. King ten suited. That's pretty big of a shove. Yeah, it was a nice hand on his part. Flopped that. We could have check called. Would have been better if we check called that hand. Unfortunate that that decision came in the midst of all this kablobbery. Besides the limp, I think our range is strong enough. We get a re-raise. Oh, oy vey, oy vey. Fifth is seven. Not many actually get paid here, but eights. Oh. Man, I'm not loving this decision. Fifth to seven, 17 big blinds. I think we have to fold. Here, can go either way. New 88. Here we have decent enough equity. 5 of 6. It's not terrible, it's not great. We go with it. C-bet in order. Let me just check. You can have a 7 here. Pocket 3s as well. And yeah, we just call ace-queen. Against an ace-king, we're in bad shape, we need a queen. Running diamonds. Spades? Nah. For now, we are in bad shape. That's unfortunate, we were in first by a long shot a moment ago. And that happened. Free exit. K9, K9, K9. Jack 9, off suit. Not great. I think we just go with it here. It's a king queen ball. We can be betting small. Not good, not terrible, obviously. 21 versus this many. Ace 4, we have the nut flush backup clubs. Trying to make everything work. Touch of hearts, not great to go with. That is a 5 though, we can't get pushed off too easily here. Ace high, like we're gonna go with it for sure. Queen 8 of clubs. Hot 10. Pretty big bet. Donk leads with a huge amount of his range. We can just fold, it's not amazing, obviously. We shove. We have ace-8, we do have to go with this. 3-5, yeah, we go with this 2. Ace-8. We are in 4 of 6, top 5 get paid. Come on, man. Let's find a way. We reshove here for sure. Obviously not amazing. It's ace and a 4 though. Would love not to have to bust. Prospects were looking so good not too long ago, then all of a sudden he kind of went to fucking busto. E7 against 10-4. Why'd he call it 10-4? He looks such in great shape right now. We need another heart. Ah, god damn it. Titties. Okay, he's gonna be betting huge into us for a lot. Where was our chips the whole time? We were high. Damn it. A negative. Queen 9 against Ace 2. Don't really want to see this. Okay, we check raise here. Check raises with some equity for sure. A lot of the time. Okay. Ace 5 is pretty good. Pretty good. Shove. King 9 can still be the best hand. Now I think it's really the best hand. Now it's definitely the best hand. What do you mean? King 6 is good enough to go with. It's a king and it's a 6. Folds. Can't continue, I think, with a queen. Let me just fold. Ace 4 also. He's gonna continue, he's gonna call. He's gonna be like, wow, that worked. Oh, the high. Jack 3 suited. Not terrible, not great. Third of six. I feel like the answer to this question is no on a test. Yes, we definitely call for sure. Ace queen against ace king. No queen, and we get another elimination. No queen. Fucking A, we get another elimination. More money. King 10, we can just jam. That's so many bigs. Queen 3 is not great. It's not terrible. Go with it. Okay, right, best hand. Yep, he's good. Can't really continue. Now we're just trying to put the hurt on for these players, you know? Trying to find a way to put the hurt on. Dun 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 dun. Just gonna call it a wider range. I have no idea where I do have time and where I don't. I feel like not too long ago we had a crush. How we rocketed back to first, I'm not really sure. 7-3. You know what? We could chip up here. 6,000. Third. 4-5. There's a couple sixes. It's not amazing. 6-5. Trumpeter. I want to see the chip graph on this one. Holy fucking Jesus. I think we can shove these cards very profitably here. Disappointed if any of it got there. It doesn't, so we can pick up those blinds. Do 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 do. Wow, we flopped a fucking straight. Look at that. Blank. Awesome. Yeah, we have ace jack, we call, obviously. Fives, he has a set, we need running spades. Now we're dead. It's unfortunate that we didn't get it. It's a huge equity pot. Should not be calling to flop a set with fives. That was incorrect on his part, but whatever. We have ace eight. I can't see a world where we don't call here. This is gonna be a huge amount of equity. Ace eight. Ace king. Ace 10. Oh, there's an ace 10. We need an eight ball. Fuck, the equity just went huge by the wayside. Huge drop. I see we call here again with a king 10 suited. He's against ace 8. We have a lot of equity against his hand. A lot of hearts. Ayo. In the money, back with the chip lead. And he got eliminated too. Wow. This is epic. It's super duper epic. Go in with it here, yeah, for sure. 8-7 against a 2-10. Yeah, we always call. Queen, he's a 10. Running hearts. Now he's a 10. We got our queen. We're good. We're real freaking good. And we have the chip loop back here. He's gonna be aggressive. He's gonna be pretty aggressive as fuck. Oh, that was pretty good. I like that. Manny Chan is gonna be doing a lot of stuff here. Orange. Yeah, we still call just in case, you never know. Okay, everything's bricked. It's fine. And we check back. Like, there's really no point in bluffing, I don't think. Jack 3, he's gonna continue. We gotta make sure we're not too passive now. Final table here. How much money is difference? 34 and 45. So $11 difference. Honestly, this game's been going on for way too long. We will call the queen 8 suited. He wants to rejam. You know what? We won't even bother. Okay. He may or may not be good. He is going to be raising us a lot. Why would he raise, though? It makes no sense as to why he's going to be raising. There's the KKK dream. Queens, a couple queens all around. Now we can do that. Pretty probably a lot of the time. We are going to call here with eights. King 10 suited. We just know that against the range of what he's going to be doing this pretty good a lot of the time. Ace queen offs we call. Ace queen against ace two. Needs a two as a miracle card. No two and we're good. We're good, my nigga. We're good. We're good. Four hundo. King is pretty good. We are going to shove a king queen 10 here. King 5, we are flipping. Come on, baby. Damn. Titties. I'm gonna check call. Why would he be betting so small? Call again. Wow, they're doing a lot of stuff to fucking me here. It's a little bit too small here. Does he bet when those come, or is he going to check pot control back? See, pot control's back. Sixes. I think we got to go with it. Sixes against threes. Fuck. So much equity in line, and this happens. Oh, you big. Oh, well, we're done. Good game. You ever want to raise here? I don't think we're going to need call my worst, to be honest, because of all that's going on. Queen 5. I'd love it if you reshoved all in. We got jacks. Come on, baby. Damn it. Speaking of it. Fucking even that kind of other shit. That's what this pair needs, I guess. Maybe check call. It's like, oi, freaking they. We found a way back up at least, right? 18-47. Call with nines. Flippy would be due. Let's see if we can get it from here. You. Four. Ace king. Nope. Fine. We'd love to just get these done. I don't think we can call. But he could be on a draw himself. Jack 10. Nice value bet. He's gonna call. He does this a lot. It's going to continue really wide. It might continue with a pretty wide range. We're going to check back again. It's obviously not great. We're just going to call. No big deal. Like, if he has it, he has it. If he doesn't, he doesn't. Which is nice. What's the payout right now for here? $17. That's pretty sick. I'm trying to find a way to make that work out for us. 14, 14, 11. Or actually, your equity's not really that great there. And here, he's going to be raising it so wide. Queen 4, though, it's not terrible in position. I would love, though, to finish up one of these tables so we can focus on these, because this is exciting. We get the final section of all of these. However, we can't really focus on any of them. I feel like he's going to jam a lot of the time here. If he just checks back, it's going to suck. Here we go. Ace king against queen four. No queen four. There's an ace. Come on, baby. There's a four. Fuck. Are you freaking kidding me? I can't win any of these. I can't finish it off. We're just trying to fucking finish it. So much equity. We got to go with jacks. Shove the king deuce suited. Jacks against nines. No nine, please. No doom switch. I'm so tired of the doom switch. Oh, come on, man. Whew. Wow, there's way too much action going on. I can't focus on anything. Here we got to shove a lot. If we limp, he's going to reshove on us. We got jacks. We got to make it bigger. I think we got a raise jam, as we do with everything, which we're going to do it here. Good call, for sure. Not going to. Okay, that's terrible for us. Our hand just got completely counterfeited. Why would he do that, though? Calls. He actually had it himself. He should not have done that, in my opinion, but whatever. At least we got some money. We do have the backdoor spade. It's a spot where you have the jack ourselves. He decided just to get frisky and called. We are in such dire straits. Oh my god, I just want to finish both of these. We check. Ace queen for both of us. Oy vey. My goodness, I'm so fatigued, but this is so fucking fun, but I'm so fatigued. I'm just trying to win. We start off at 250. We had 236. We're going to get lots of money, but we got to find a way to get even more money. 31 bigs, 32 bigs. We're super deep in the 27. 29 versus this, though. Not deep at all here. Yeah, we'll call. It's not terrible. Seven, four, suited. It's a four. I feel like he's going to be bluffing here a lot. He's not going to actually have it. We check back. Look at his bet sizing and make the decision. We're going to let him bluff. We have the best hand a lot of the time here, I find. Call. He has queen eight. We're going to limp call this one. He shoves the call. Come on, baby. 6-5. Oh my god. He's going to 3-bet everything that he has. He's doing this with flush draws a lot of the time, I find. He just won't fucking die. This way I won't fucking die. He's got it now. That's fine. This whale won't fucking die. I just want to get the fucking money. I want to get the extra 11 bucks I deserve. I can't fucking get it. Sometimes everything just doesn't work out. We're going to do our best, though. Fucking bink everything. 6-4 against... Okay, we all have this many bigs. It's going to call. We have the open-ender now. We're going to lead. He actually decides to do it. If he sees weakness, he goes with it. He wants to reshove. Okay, we go with it. King queen against pocket nines for flipping. Oh my god, this is huge. Come on, let's get there. Nope, spade, fucking eight. We're good, we finally fucking won. Holy fucking shit. We finally won. Boom, we won the 18 man. Boom, we have a decent part of this board. Come on, let's win the 27 man as well. Okay, we got that. We got that. Come on, daddy, let's bring it fucking home. Third place, it's $30. We're gonna have $312 at least. It's either 30 or 63. We wanna get another 30 bucks here. This is huge, all of these spots. Tens is something we definitely go with. If we get 3-bet, we 4-bet jam all in. If they 4-bet jam, we call. Tens are way too strong to give up. We're getting at least 312 bucks, which I'm ecstatic about. We're going to 4-bet jam. For sure, I mean, this is too hard to play tens on a lot of flops. You're going to get overcards about half the time, or even a little bit more. We're going to jam the ace-six as well. Just because they're opening wide on the button. So it's definitely doing well against the range of hands that they're going to be opening there. King-9 suited, we're going to attack this and just shove it right into space. It's going to be hard for him to have a better hand. King-9 against Queen-10, so we are actually leading. Doesn't go either way. Boom! Heads up, motherfucker. Let's go. How much money? Guaranteed $45. Let's fucking go. 45 on top of this. 50. 200. 300 fucking 27. Let me fucking go, motherfucker. Now let's get another 18 bucks. Let's do this. It's gonna be like, what? We're gonna check. If he check raises, we re-raise. Or just flat. No, we look at the stack sizes. We gotta make sure we do the play that makes sense. Okay, we're deep. We're gonna call here with our 8-7 suited. Flop a pair of sevens. Looks like a check call so far. Still a check call. We don't have backdoor hearts anymore. Now all we have is a pair of sevens. Check call. A lot of bets here that he puts out. We have a seven. We continue. We win it. Gotta do whatever we freaking can here. We have a huge amount of chips. This is massive. We're gonna try and win this one as well. Do whatever we can. We're gonna try and steal a lot from him. C-bets and stuff like that. He's gonna be re-raising. Put in some C-bets. Stuff like that. If he dog leads into us, though, I think you gotta fold this hand. Not gonna be a lot that we can do. Except I like the idea of 26ing. Very decent part of this hand. If he re-raises on this, we do have to get rid of it. We're not gonna, like, call or anything. But he just looks really weak to, like, a try and steal. But he could be trying to bait us, in which case we'll know for future. He does this. Why wouldn't he? You know what? He really wants action. We're just gonna fold. That's why we shouldn't play too many bad hands. They're not going to fold as often as they really should. He's from Austria. When was the last Canadian? A while back. We are just going to actually call the 3-4. See what he does. If he wants to raise it, you know what? We'll see. That's an amazing flop, though, for 3-4. For sure. Do our classic 55% after one thing. King 6 of hearts, we will definitely just call. Actually, if he wants to do that, we're going to make it bigger for him. He hasn't done this a lot. He's probably doing this with weak holding. He would raise a stronger holding for sure. If he re-raises us here, I think we have to go with it. He's going to have a weak holding a lot of the time here. We got to start betting at fair size, I think. He's going to have a lot of middling cards. If he re-raises all in, he's got to have some sort of clean thing, but he would raise that. This makes no freaking sense at all. We can't call. He would have 10-9 a lot. What hands is he doing this with? He limps. He's going to have a 10,000. It's a really high variance spot. It's definitely a really high variance spot. I think we know for the future what we can do. I just think that he's going to have hands like ace-3 a lot of the time here as well. Hands that he thinks he's bluffing with, but he actually has the best hand. So we'll know for future. He likes to raise those. I'm thinking he's just getting really aggressive. I think that's too high a variance spot to call, even though I think there's a good amount of time that we're ahead. Jack two suited. We have no three betting range right now. Basically, heads up. We will do it with like an ace, because I still feel like when we three bet, he's going to call far too often. He's like, oh my god, did that bluff work? Like, no, it didn't. Like, we know his bluff. We just can't call. He probably bluffed the best hand, but if he didn't, then nice hand, you know? We're going to fold this. I was thinking about three betting. If I three bet, I should do it a little faster. This is all over his range for sure. He donkeys, I think we got to fold. 20,000 chips. 20,000. An hour 47. This could run a lot longer still. Ace 6. Don't really want 3-bet too much yet. I think 3-betting is decent, but it's not amazing. Hand where we had 8-7. We had 5-6. We already had a pair. Everything's getting there for him right now. When he bets this big. I think he got a fold. King Queen is the only thing that's not there, and even then it's got a huge amount of equity. Not loving that we're losing chips right now. Kind of have to go to the bathroom, to be honest. Alright, I think you gotta check raise the next hand, to be quite honest. Bum, bum, bum. Trying to just keep doing what we need to do. Like, we shouldn't play too high variant spots, even though we are tired. There's $18 at stake here, which is a lot more than you think it might be. King 6 2, we can play a lot of these hands in position. Looks like we got a fold. I got a piss real freaking bad. This break can't get here soon enough. Let me just check to see how much time make we have, actually. It's not bad, not terrible. We'll raise using some bets and chip. He's not 3 bets yet. Pre-flop. We may start that soon. We have been plummeting. Can't let him control. Can't let him fucking control. Well, fucking control. He's trying to control us. No. We will control you. A lot of the time, can't really continue to deuce. When he bets big, he seems to have it, although, of course, he does it too often, he's not going to great. We're going to 3-bet this hand. No, we're not. The fucking 3x and 4. Haven't connected with any flops, although I know heads up, you're only supposed to connect with 1/3 of them. He's 3x for the first time, though, which makes me seem like he's strong. He is just wearing me down. Fuck. I am really pissed off, and I got to do something about this. How are we going to fucking beat this motherfucker? We got to start 3-betting some stuff, honestly. I think we limp jam here. It's good. It's real good. He's just folding whenever he doesn't have him. It looks like. He raises though, we do go with it. He's gonna be raising with a lot of semi hands. 5-6 would suck. That would real suck. Gotta find a way to get back into this match. Can't really call speculative hands now. We got 19 big blinds. Gotta jam a lot of stuff. It's gonna be 3xing a lot. We actually have not jammed at all. Three plot or pre-flop. We have not done that stuff. Limp jam this hand for sure. 5-8. He doesn't have an ace a lot of the time. We both could have the 8. I just feel like too often he doesn't have it. Story makes no sense. 9-10 suited's pretty decent. Pretty decent for sure. There we go. Smashing them flops. Come on, Donkley. You know you want it. What do we do about this? We let him barrel. Oh my god, this is amazing. Here we fucking go, motherfucker. Ace three, we got you. There's just no fucking way, man. He's like, oh yeah, oh shit. That's literally just happening. Oh yeah, oh shit. We call. If he wants to jump, we call. With a huge hand. Huge. You want to go with it? Let's just roll with it, bro. Let's just fucking go with it. Dude, you gotta call. Eights against a king jack? Come on, baby. I feel it. I feel it. Come on, king jack river. Dang, girl. Okay, you know what? We keep playing. Play on, play on. I got you. I got you. You do with equity. We raise, you jam, I call. I got you. We can finish this before the break. We just gotta know what we're doing whenever we do it. Do 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 do. We just take a picture. We don't need to boom it, I don't think. You know what? Let's boom this motherfucker. Share on motherfucking boom. Share on motherfucking boom. We have 43 seconds for our time bank. Are there any deals available? I feel like there aren't. King 5 suited. Well, that's a jam. Because we haven't jammed a lot on him. He shan't be expecting us too often. That was a massive equity pot. How often is he going to rejam on us, right? Let's see. I feel like he's going to be folding quite a bit. On this stack size, I feel like he's going to be like trying to find the best hand. So it's going to be fairly transparent what he's going to be doing. 3xing makes not much sense, so we can re-raise a little bit wider, I think. Let's see if he starts jamming. Or he takes the free cards. He does take the free cards. I think we let him barrel. How much sense does 2400 make? Very little. 6-7. Damn it. Ace 2, we go with it for sure. We could easily lose. We're trying to do the best we can not to lose. With the 7 and the ace. If he donks, what does it mean? Gonna be 8. We're not gonna raise though this time. Just gonna call. He probably doesn't help him. He's usually donked with a lot of different kind of equity cards. We're just gonna check back. Let him barrel any sort of river. 10-9 did just get there. I feel like he would have kept barreling with 10-9. He could have a jack in his range. There's a lot of different cards he could have in his range here. We are gonna call and see what kind of things he checks back on the turn. A 5-6. Okay, that makes sense. This is a good heads-up match. He is bluffing a lot in bad ways. We take advantage of that for sure. We're gonna fold this. We don't really need to play every hand. Plans that play a little better, a bit better, to say the least. 3-7's not great. Just check. Check. Check fold, I think, on this one. We're making it pretty good, though. Why would you raise, though, after checking that flop? Makes very little sense. Here, I feel like he's gonna call us pretty light. We're just gonna check fold. 8-7 high. 8-7 high. Dude, that doesn't make me feel very good. Both have a pair of nines. It's pretty good. Could have kings. Could easily have a king. I don't know how much I want to get it in though. We'll evaluate our decision once he raises, because I feel like he's going to raise, but does he ever raise here with a king? king with a 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 king king king. We'll call. That's a really good card for us. Very unlikely to have a king now. And a lot of his over cards that he could be bluffing with, we can just call a lot now. He jams, we call. I got simply about it. I think now we jam. You have a king, nice hand. Oh. That's real gross. All right, well, he got us with a better full house in the end. Try and run it back up, but I think that's probably going to be a second place for us. Jack 10 against a king 9. That is a 9, but he's got jack and 10. No, we're still alive. Nice. Try to find a way. Get another reshove in here, maybe. I'll just do whatever we can in the time being. I mean, I'll check it. It's fine. I mean, you want to see a flop? Sure. Stop and go. Let's fucking go. 5 minute break. So unfortunately we fell down here. I'm back, took my piss, Rooney. I got like 300 something. It's gonna be pretty freaking sick. That's a sick ROI for this session. This stuff's got it. And we gotta try to find a way for the win. We're doing really well. Then he somehow got away. Really not too sure how. The King 7 hand, that was huge. Huge, huge, huge. Lines are pretty high, 20,200. Actually, not too high. We're just playing aggressively huge pots. So what happened? King 5. Ah, oh, he got that one. Yeah. Well, hear me out, so yeah, right? He had an 8, 7, a 6, and a 3. 4, 4, 3, 3. Okay. 10, 14 outs. 20%. On a flop, 14 outs is actually really freaking high. So it's basically a flip. The heads up matches that take the longest. Oh my god, these are mentally draining as fuck. So obviously, we're not gonna. Well, obviously, but I'm not gonna play anymore. Games we got these players with head fat, Black Baron, Van Ricky and shit with head fat. Sarah Trump. Why isn't Trump in there? It makes no sense. Anyway, with the games that are going on, not a huge fan. 282. This is sick. For $253. $253, at least $227. Likely $227. We could hopefully get more. They're 18 would be sick. 327 would be 345. That'd be almost $100 in the session. Way above EV. Ace King, we go with that, obviously. Damn it! He folded. Fucking titties. Hi, babe. We go with King 3 suited. For sure. Here we go. Here we go. Would have preferred the Ace King, but Queen 3 suited might have to do it. Lol, he calls it the Queen 5. Ace King. Shit. So sadly, we did end up winning. Tony B 1988. Sharks go. Guy's 8 years older than me, which means that he is 27. How good is this guy anyway? Hardly. Probably ecstatic. It's too bad we couldn't get them to work out. However, they got some good monies. We got some good money for sure. $328. Boom. All right. Good game, everybody. I'm going to put the shark scope on in a sec. Make sure that I'm not involved in any of these. Good for Trump. I don't think I'm involved in any of these still. Okay. Let's shark scope me. Ah, fucker. Why did I search him up? It's more important than searching on me. That's sick. Nice. Okay, we'll get on the session. 320.